Hello, I'm Toby from Germany.
And I'm Julia.
And we travel with our van Fino, Volkswagen Crafter from 2014, this summer through Greece.
This video is sponsored by One Day University. Get 1 month free and 50% off the annual membership by clicking the link in the description and using code FLORB at checkout.
When we met each other, we knew directly that we both like going on a journey with a van, and our first van was a Mercedes Sprinter. We bought it from the Fire Defender in Berlin. We drove to Italy in our first holiday.
We had to convert it two times more to find the ultimate version for our first Fino. And after we finished the conversion, we said, okay, let's buy another one and buy a bigger one. So we bought this one from 2014. It was about 12,000 euro. The conversion took us round about 7 months. In total, we probably spent round about 25,000 euro for the van and the conversion. It was quite a lot of work, but it was fun also. So we learned so much about converting this van, and it was just great, yeah. We bought a Volkswagen from 2014, which had around about 40,000 kilometers on the clock. It's in a pretty good shape. And the roof rack was pretty important for us. It makes life easier if you want to put a solar panel on the roof or, for example, a terrace. Right now, we don't have a terrace, but maybe we're going to build this in the future. We have a 300-watt solar panel, goes straight into our 280-amp-hour lithium battery. This is our ladder to the roof rack. We bought this one for around about 100 euro, and then I painted it black, so it fits just a bit better to the van. Let's have a look at our garage. Our highlight in the garage is our boxes. They don't look sexy, but they're very useful, because we can put so much stuff inside. For example, our hose for the water tank. I have here some tools to repair the van if necessary. Under the bedroom, we have our lithium iron phosphate battery, the water tank, 125 liters, our boiler and our diesel heater. We have two options to heat up our boiler: electricity, and we can use our diesel heater. A lot of warm air outside the diesel heater. It goes through the boiler. On our last van, we had no awning, but the sun, especially in the southern part of Europe, is so hot. The awning was very important for us. And the roof rack is pretty useful there too, because we just put it on the roof rack. Let's have a look inside. One of our highlights in our van is this special pattern plywood. Actually, I saw some videos on YouTube. I like this pattern, so we have to do this in our van. We bought a normal plywood and cut it in many, many stripes and then glued it together. You can make lots of different patterns. So for example, it's on the table, it's in the kitchen. We have it here in our bathroom. And the last thing I want to show you is the control panel. So we have here two outlets. The one is the power from the inverter. Our inverter has a 2500 watt. And the other is electricity from outside when we are on a camping place or something like that. So we have here different switches for the light, for the kitchen, and the boiler with this switch. This one is for the freezer, and this one is for our whole water system. So we have in our van here water and in the bathroom.
I will show you first our dining room. Here you can see two seats, and here also our driving seats. So we can turn the driving seats around, and we can also put the table down to have a guest bed if we have some guests here. We just need to put a mattress on it and one person have the possibility to sleep here. Up here we have some mixed storage, some kitchen stuff and medical supplies, some mixed electric things. At all boxes we have the push locks, because if we drive through curvy roads, everything will fall out, but we can just push here and then everything is locked. Okay, here is our big window. We have some mosquito net to be safe. And also we can put this one and then everything is dark inside. Underneath the table, we have some storage for shoes. We have two boxes there. Here we have our 12-volt fridge. It's a small one, but it's enough for us. And we also have a really, really tiny freezer inside here. Underneath the fridge, we have some space for our waste bin and also some bottles like oil and so on. Then in our workshop, we have a big sink because in our last van, the sink was so small and it was so difficult to wash the dishes. So here it's more comfortable to wash dishes. Here we have some drawers with more kitchen things. We have our cutting plate and our bowls and our pots for cooking, more dishes and also a bit of food. And in the last one, we stored everything for the kitchen where we found no other place. So yeah, it's a mixed drawer. On the top of our kitchen, we have some spices, our coffee and some stuff we need daily. Then here we have the wardrobe of Tobias. So he has his clothes here. For me, it was very important to have a mirror inside for my vintage online shop. Sometimes I do videos in front of the mirror. Then this one is also with clothes from Tobias. Here are his socks. This one too, with some clothes, some shirts from him. And this one is really important for us because we cook with a portable gas stove. I will show you this. It's very comfortable because we can cook here if we like to, or we can stay it here and we can cook here, or if it's hot outside, we can cook outside. So it's a really good thing. Here we have some bathroom things and some bed sheets and towels. And it's a really, really big drawer, so we can store here a lot of things. Here are mostly of our bathroom things. Underneath this step, which leads us to our bedroom, we have more place. It goes up there and there, so it's a lot of place. Okay, now I will show you our bathroom. We have here some storage for shower gel and so on. Underneath we have our compost toilet. We build it completely by our own. We use this. We need it for our compost toilet. We covered the whole bathroom with plastic because we like to have a shower inside here. And it's no problem, everything can be wet. This curtain I sewed by my own. I bought the fabric at Etsy. It divides our bedroom from the rest of our van. Here is also the pattern plywood again. We repeated it here. And we have our books here. This side is nearly full with my clothes, and I also need some space if I buy more clothes in the vintage shops. More books and electric things, and also everything is with this push lock so nothing can fall out. Or here also some electric things and some books, so it's a lot of storage place. You can see in the back also some curtains, which I also sewed by my own, and we covered the whole backside with wool. Yes, I love it.
First of all, it's very important that you think about it. What do you want to do with the car? If you want to go just at the weekend for a few days, then it's totally okay if your camper van is a bit smaller. Is it important for me to go off-road? Which kind of model you want to buy? I prefer Mercedes or VW, because I think they have good engines.
Also think that it's very important to plan how the van should look inside. We made the mistake with the first one that we changed it 3 times and it was no fun. So make a sketch with your hands, with a pencil or with your computer, but plan it really good before doing it.
When you're building a van, I think it's important that you are patient with yourself. At the beginning, it takes some time to learn what works best. So give yourself a bit time to go into this learning process.
One Day University brings together over 200 of the top-rated professors from universities all across the country to present you with live stream talks every weekday afternoon. And all of these talks are available on demand after the fact. Professors are selected from the most popular instructors at schools including Yale, Stanford, Harvard, UCLA, Duke, Michigan, Columbia, and many more. Each live talk is just 1 hour and is followed by a live Q&A session with the professor. Members also get access to a library with over 500 past recorded talks available on demand. Learn something new every day about dozens of topics, including history, politics, art, science, music, psychology, and much, much more. There's no homework or tests, just the joy of learning new things from incredible professors. Memberships are $8.95 a month or just $89 a year, but One Day University is offering you guys a great deal. If you click the link in the description, you can get full access to One Day University for a month. And then if you use offer code FLORB at checkout, you can get 50% off the annual membership. So I recommend you check that out. Head over to onedayu.com/FLORB and sign up today. Thank you for watching and have a great week.